In this video, I'm going to show you how to elevate your small business's social presence by transforming your visuals with ease using the background remove tool in Adobe Express, the quick and easy create anything app. I'm going to show you how to quickly remove distracting backgrounds from your images and how you can turn a boring image like this one into a captivating graphic to help your posts look more polished and fun. The background removal tool is an essential tool in design because it allows you to isolate and highlight specific elements of an image, making your visuals cleaner and more focused. If you're going to upload your own photo, you're going to come up here to plus, you're going to come here to upload media, you're going to select your image, and then you are going to upload it. But for me, I'm going to be using a stock photo today. I'm going to select this image here. When I select it, I'm just going to go create new, original aspect ratio, and that's just going to bring in that photo at its original size. And when I click on the image, we have a lot of options here that kind of come up. So if I click the background removal tool, it removes the background, but it doesn't remove some of the other things. So we're gonna wanna clean this up a little bit. We're gonna use the circle brush. I'm just going to change the size of this to make it nice and big. And we're just going to paint over the things in the image that we do not want. So if we use our hand tool, we can kind of click while we're holding the space bar and drag it around and really get into the details here so we can remove the stuff in the photo that we don't want. If we accidentally move our brush and take out a chunk of the couch, we can just go Command Z or come up here to undo, or we can go restore and we can paint back what we accidentally got rid of. What we can do is come to background color, no fill, and now we have just the couch cut out with a transparent background. We can download this image as a PNG. The PNG is going to maintain the transparency. If you save it as a JPEG, it will add a white background automatically. Now that we have our image, we're not really gonna stop there. We're actually gonna make an Instagram post out of this photo. So we're gonna wanna make sure that we're choosing the correct resolution. So for an Instagram in feed, that's 1080 pixels wide by 1350 pixels high. Don't worry about committing these sizes to memory. Adobe Express has all of the up-to-date social media sizes available for you to start from or resize into. So if we select the image, any of these white nodes, we can start scaling up and down. We can drop the opacity, so that just makes it transparent. We can flip the couch up and down. We can set it as the background. We can do a duotone. That's actually what I'm gonna do here. Because we're not selling this couch, we're just making a promotional post. This couch might not even be available. The duotone basically just makes your image two different colors. Okay, I have my couch duotone finalized and I'm gonna add a background color by coming up to background color and playing around until I see something I like. So the client creative brief says that they need a slide that says seasonal sale up to 50% off. There's actually no client brief. I just made that up. 50% off is the most important. Like if I'm buying a couch, like yeah, I want like 50% off. That's gonna be the biggest thing. And then seasonal sale might be the smaller things. In order to add text, we are gonna come over to the left. There's all sorts of things here on the side, templates, media, text, elements. We're gonna go text. Lots of cool text options here. You can even search text. What if we went sale? What is this one? I like this. When we click on and add the graphic to our board, it comes in as one big piece, right? But these are two different pieces of text. These are grouped right now. So we can either keep it grouped and just double click on the text that we wanna edit, or we can select it and come up here to ungroup. So we're just gonna edit 40% off and change that to 50% off. And this weekend only, we're gonna add seasonal sale. I find that this seasonal sale font here is like a little bit flat. Just kind of try on different typefaces here. And we're actually going to change the color of seasonal sale because I think black just feels like a little jarring. So we'll go fill color. And then we might go with the eyedropper tool and we might just come over here and pick this pink. Once I have an idea of the color scheme, I'll start adjusting my text and colors to get my graphic to a point where I'm happy with it. By coming over and searching for different media, I can look for images that can add some interest, like fabric textures. Then I will start layering them to make the graphic look a little more dynamic. And we're just kind of adjusting our opacity. Because our couch is cut out, has a transparent background, we use the background removal tool to get rid of that background. We can also put text behind it. If we come over to our layers here, we can actually select our text, grab them and put them below the couch. And now they are behind the couch. Here's where we can add a shadow. Obviously this classic drop shadow doesn't look that good, but what if we went with like a strong shadow and we can customize that by coming over here to custom and we can change the angle and we can change the distance and we're gonna change the color of this to the same pink that we have in our text. We can also add a shape behind our text and then customize the size and color in the window on the left. Once we're happy with the text, I'll go in and add more effects and images in the background and using the same techniques to change the color and opacity and tweak things again until I'm happy with the result. So we have our graphic kind of done here. If we want to save this here, we can come up to download We're going to select either just the one page that we've designed or all pages. Once we have that downloaded, we can stick that up on Instagram and use it as our promotion. So as you can see, enhancing your images using the background removal tool can really boost your small business promotions for promotions and engaging social media content. Use eye-catching imagery to grab attention and drive sales, right? You're gonna wanna create custom designs with those images that help your product and your message stand out more clearly. When you're showcasing products, say on your webpage, you can actually use this tool to clip out the background of your images and then change the color of that background, whether it be a color, black or white. And this is a really easy way to make your product images look much cleaner and more professional and potentially more appealing to your customers as well. So that's how to use the background removal tool in Adobe Express to transform your images for social media, just make things look a lot better. For more tips and tricks on how to elevate your small business, check out the Adobe Express channel.